They say the grass is greener on the outside. So how do you know you're not better off dead than alive? I questioned, how would I know if I'm better off without him if I keep him in my life? I couldn't fathom letting him go, though. He was my sugar. I was his spice. The combination of us together was like a Starbucks latte. Chai. He said, going through the motions, spending extended time apart, builds character. But for me, having to live even one day without him felt like torture. I tried dating others, but they could not measure. I tried forgetting about him, but I couldn't. He was my guilty pleasure. The soul connection between the two of us was no other, and the passion we shared for one another was unheard of. Yes, with him, there was an instant connection, but in exchange, I received a lover who held hidden secrets, lies, and fabrications, no confessions. I received a lover who on the low was through with love. In fact, he was love's rebel. And I wondered why he never fully let me in, even though I made it my business to. It was as if he detested love just as Jesus detested the devil. I could tell with me he felt ambivalent. Feelings which prevented him from allowing me to call it quits. Yup, I broke up with him on several occasions because he failed to do what he needed to make me commit. But I had it bad and kept accepting him back with the expectation that he'd change and treat me the way I deserved to be treated. I had it bad. I thought he was my beginning and my end. I had it so bad, I thought he was my first true love and my last. But he wasn't. I tried letting him go often, but his magnetic force kept pulling me back in. I felt like I was losing it. No one had ever had so much power over me with him. I understood love, and I was a fool for it. With him, my heart constantly and rapidly beat, but his couldn't catch up as it was clogged with past hurts, bitterness, and vivid memories of deceit. I wanted so desperately to get back those moments when our love once flowed. Back to when there were no hiccups, no expectations, no guards, and no fears, just the peace of our souls connecting and an unbreakable bond we once desired to share. With no expiration date, a connection with limitless days, endless nights, and infinite years, I remember when I sat in tears, wishing that the number of years I lived my life were more closely aligned with his, so that his mind could be further open, his faith stronger, and every fiber of his being less scared. And I sat and reminisced about the love and dislike letters we both sent, like the one I wrote him when he stood me up on Valentine's Day weekend and showed a lack of regard given how hard I had worked to plan such an occasion. Or like the one he wrote me when he played the victim and accused me of dumping him every other weekend and said I was the reason why we weren't meant. How can he blame me for controlling what's meant to be? Clearly he didn't believe like I believe. He didn't believe that God is almighty and the creator of what's meant to be. And evidently he wasn't meant for me. So I took time out of life just for me. And I freed my mind of any possibility of us getting back together. And I established new measures of love. New measures that didn't include a man of flesh, but the man up above. A love consisting of nothing other than the atoms I was made of. And now I stand. No tears, fears abolished, confident, patient, poised, and in love with me. All because I had a love epiphany. It opened my eyes and it made me see. It gave me faith and it made me believe that God and only God will bring to me the king created specifically for this queen.